What's up, guys? It's Jay, more than Afterkill, and I'm back here on Gotham City, motherfucking Impostors. That's right. For those of you guys that are new to my channel, this is a game that I used to play and post every single motherfucking day until I got annoyed and tired of the problems that the game had. It had a real problem with lag and disconnecting me out of the game and throwing me all the way back to the dashboard. And that is very, very annoying, especially when you're kicking some motherfucking ass. So this is my first game back, and I decided, you know what, I had a pretty decent game. It's July 4th, it's a holiday, it's a real nice, easy day, real kind of chill. So I was like, you know what, fuck it, I'm gonna do something different and just give you guys a commentary over something pretty old. It's kind of like a throwback. So anyway, let me tell you guys a story, because, you know, even though today is an easy and chill day, the other day wasn't, because if you've been following my channel, you know that I have been building my man cave up over the last year. Little by little, it has been getting better and better. Right now, I almost have it complete. I have my desk set up. I have two brand new PCs that were given to me. One of them was given to me by Cyberpower. The other one I purchased. But, you know, they are awesome. And I have my whole setup going pretty good right now. And I decided I needed a couch. Now, I'm a little bit lazy when searching for things, and I'm a little bit cheap too. So usually online, you can get the best deals on a lot of things if you purchase and have it delivered, right? So I found this awesome looking motherfucking three-piece sectional couch, and I was like, man, it's black, it's gray, you know, my desks are black and chrome, my mic is black and chrome, everything in my room is black and chrome. So I was like, you know what? Getting a black and gray couch is gonna be amazing. So let's go ahead and order. It is only $600 motherfucking dollars for this couch. How bad can it be, you know? $600 now for a couch is actually kind of cheap, but in the long run, $600 is still a decent amount of money to expect a decent quality product to come in the mail. Now, this couch actually took 3 fucking weeks to be shipped. So I called him up and I was like, dude, what are you guys building my motherfucking couch? Apparently they motherfucking were, because this couch came in a box. What? Now usually when you order furniture, it shows up at your house with like two dudes and they fucking bring it in, they set it up, they put the couch in, you know, they gotta tilt it this way, that way to get it through the goddamn doorway. You know what I'm talking about. Not this box. This box came with one dude with a goddamn pallet jack, and he just dropped it off on the motherfucking curb out front on a pallet in a box. And I was like, there's no way possible that a couch is in this motherfucking box. So I grab a knife, just take off all the fucking saran wrap on the outside. It's actually heat shrink wrap, but I call it saran wrap anyway. So I start dragging these motherfucking boxes in. It's like 100-degree fucking heat out. And I'm dragging this shit in, and I start opening it up, and I'm like, what the fuck is this? Apparently, this couch comes in pieces. And I was like, man, if I was gonna order a couch that had to be put together, I might as well just took my lazy ass to fucking IKEA and picked it out off the fucking showroom and put it together my goddamn self. And even IKEA now actually has a service to where they will deliver and put that shit together for you. But you know what? I am a mechanic. I'm mechanically inclined. I'm not really worried about this. I'm like, let's put this fucking couch together. I look on the instructions. It says 10 minutes for assembly. And it said the same thing on the internet ad that I bought it on. And when I first saw that, I was like, oh man, probably just have to put legs on it and fucking put it together. No, no. This thing, I actually literally had to put together from fucking scratch. I mean, I had to hold the back there, fucking tilt the couch this way, put the washer in with the fucking, yeah. It was that literally fucking intensive to put this couch together. And the only person I had there to help me was my girlfriend. Now, if you follow me on Twitter, you will know that this debacle happened live on Twitter. I was tweeting out this 10 minutes of assembly ended up being 3 hours of the most painstaking labor you have ever seen to put together a motherfucking couch. So I'm trying to get this together and I'm putting all the bolts in, you know, you want to make sure that you get the bolts in just loosely first before you tighten anything down to make sure there's no adjustments that you have to make, right? I know that as a mechanic, and I start looking And these bolt holes are not lining up. So I'm thinking my girlfriend's doing something wrong. I'm like, baby, take the tension off the bolt. It's going to break. She's like, I don't know what you're doing. I started screaming at her. She let go. The whole fucking end of the couch fucking fell off. Hit me in the motherfucking eye. I'm like, ah! And I fucking go on Twitter. I'm like, don't ever ask your girlfriend to help you put shit together. And it finally got to the point to where I was like, all right, I'm going to go get a drill. And I look inside the shed, and the only fucking drill I have is an air compressor drill. And I don't have a motherfucking air compressor. Fuck! I asked the neighbor. No, the neighbor is not home. So what I ended up doing was taking my green Matco mallet and beating the shit out of this fucking couch until the bolt holes lined up. And the moral of the story is, my couch is now sitting there looking motherfucking beautiful because I had to beat it with a hammer. So if you ever have a problem, motherfucker, it's hammer time. Oh, can't touch this. So, my name is Jay. More than after kill. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. I want to thank you guys for watching. I just wanted to share that little bit of frustration for you because it was an easy day. And you guys had an easy day. And I wanted to tell you about a frustrating day because it's funny. And it makes me feel better. So, like I said, my name is Jay Morton After Kill. Make sure you guys rate, comment, subscribe. I want to thank you guys for watching. If you could throw a thumbs up on the video, I would highly appreciate it because it gives me motivation to make more videos for you motherfuckers that watch my motherfucking videos. I'm going to see you guys later.